Good morning. Welcome to the English class. Today we are going to learn a very interesting lesson. Before we would enter the lesson, I would like to share with you a small story. A frog decided to reach the top of the tree. Other frogs shouted, "It's impossible, it's impossible, you can't climb it, you can't do it." Everybody shouted, but frog never minded. It reached the top. Do you know how? It was deaf. He thought that other fox was encouraging him to reach the top. Do you like this story? Of course, all of you like this story. If your aim is to reach your goal, be deaf to negative thoughts. Shall we move on to the lesson? Our prescribed lesson is Unit 4, 11th Standard English. Type corner. It is written by A.V. Lucas. A.V. Lucas is in a full form is Edward Barrow Lucas. The type corner means is in a critical situation, difficult situations. Gist of the story I will say. Our narrator went with his friend in a Christie shop, and I mean is in an action sale hall. Action means that is in a public sale hall. Both of them went to the shop. The narrator knew nothing about art pictures and not enough had money also in his pocket to participate in the bidding. He had only 63 pounds in the bank. The action started and the narrator, not understanding seriousness, he also started raising the bid amount marginally. A rich man bid 4,000 guineas. The narrator just fun. Raised the bid amount by 50 guineas more. The narrator thought that someone would raise the bid further, but no one bid after him. He unwittingly got into mental type corner. Finally, the gent who had made 4,000 guineas would offer him the additional 50 guineas and buy the picture. He had got relief from his mental type corner. This is the gist of the story. I hope you understood the story. Is it clear? Now shall we move on? Glossary. Brittany. Brittany is not at all is in a biscuit. It's in a place in France. A region on the coast of north west France. It's in a coastal area. St. James Street, King Street. Well-known commercial streets in London. Commercial streets, all the goods available in the streets in London. Plutocrat. Plutocrat means a fat and rich person of high station, a term coined by E.V. Lucas by blending the words blotter and aristocrat. Blending words is nothing else. Listen, all of you. Previous class, previous standard, we have studied compound word. Compound word is, what's the meaning of compound word? Two different words combined together to form a new word. That is called compound word. Blended word also is in a two different word, not combined, is mixed together. That one is called a blended word. That is in a, briefly I will say in a later class. Is it clear all of you? Next, electrified. Shocked by something unexpected. Crescendo, progress towards a climax. Congealed, thickened as if frozen. Smothered, suppressed. Nonchalantly, unconcernedly or coolly. Deeply, smoothly but not sincerely. Note of and, promissory note. Rectitude, honesty, good behavior. Farthing, as low as a paise. Vice, coarse, full and material. Guile, cunning deceit, indelible, cannot be rubbed out or removed. Indelible is a kind of ink. Shall we move on to the lesson? Picture by picture I will show you. It's easy for you to understand. It's easy for you to be capture it also. Tight corners mean difficult situation or critical situations. There are two types of tight corners. One is physical tight corners, another one is mental tight corners. Physical tight corners is easy to bear it, but mental tight corners is not able to bear it. Physical tight corners is affected by any other accident or disease. Easy, we go to that hospital, is easy to cure it also. But mental tight corner is very, very difficult to cure it. Our narrator, how he was affected in tight corners, so how he has relieved from his mental tight corner, let's see the lesson. I will going to explain you picture by picture. Is it clear? About the author, Edward Vera Lucas was born on June 1868 and he has died 26 June 1938. He was an English humorist, essayist, playwright, biographer, publisher, poet, novelist, short story writer and editor. From this we came to know he was a multi-talented person. He was born to Quaker family in Eltham on the fringes. Fringes means it's in a border. Eltham is in a place of London. Is it clear? Lucas began work at the age of 16. In his early age, he was apprenticed into a bookseller. Many of us have unused old but valuable items at home. If we wish to get rid of them, we can sell them at an auction. The flow chart below will help you understand how an auction is conducted. Auction means is in a public sale. Is it clear? Now we are going to see the line by line. Enter the sale room where the items are displayed for sale and decide the item you wish to buy. Next, first of all, you have to be registration number from the staff. The auctioneer opens by quoting a price. Auctioneer is a person, head of auction, opens by quoting a price for each article. Each buyer holds up his her card and states a price which is higher than the opening price. The auction continues with each bidder. Bidder means is one who buy the articles, one who buy the old materials from auction. That person called bidder, quoting a higher price until the item is considered sold. The deal is closed with the highest bidding or price. The highest price is announced thrice. The highest bidder finally goes to the clerk and hand over the card. The payment is made by check or any other approved mode of payment, and the article is considered sold. In this way, auction is conducted by the auctioneer. Is it clear? In the beginning of the lesson, five of them were talking about the critical situations. And the talk was running on the critical situations in which they had found themselves. One man had been caught by the Brittany and escaped by the skin of his teeth. Brittany, we already studied in a glossary. A region on the coast of northwest France
coastal area. Skin of his teeth is in a idiom. Narrow escape from disaster. So one man has caught by the coastal area and he had escaped from his physical cornice. Is it clear? Another man had an elephant when a wounded tiger charged it. He has escaped from his physical cornice. Third had been on the top story of a burning house. He also escaped from his physical affairs. Fourth one was torpedoed in the great war, bomb blast. He also escaped from his physical cornice. So four of them were talking as if tight corners were caused by the physical affairs. E.V. Lucas told, when he was at Christie's, he had experienced the tightest corner. All of them asked, what is Christie's? The Christie's was founded in 1766. Private sales of the finest art jewelry, watches, etc. Narrator, how he was affected in the mental trade corner, he going to explain it. The narrator and his friend who came from abroad, had lunch in James Street. After they have finished the lunch, while they were crossing King Street, the narrator's friend persuaded him to look in at the sale room. Is it clear? Next, they were selling Barbizon pictures for tremendous prices. This is Barbizon pictures. It's not at all, it's in a photo, it's in a real picture. One who has drawn the picture. It looks like in a real picture. So narrator found himself bidding two just for fun. The narrator had only 63 pounds and he had no securities even to borrow 500. In this condition, he was bidding like a wealthy person. A short red-faced man shocked the room by the way of bidding at a higher value. When the new picture was displayed, a rich man made his sensational bid for 4,000 guineas. As usual, just for fun, the narrator raised the bid by 50 guineas more. The narrator thought that someone would raise the bid further, but nobody else bid after him. The auctioneer repeated the bid amount of 4,050 thrice a time, 4,050, 4,050, and asked any more bids for the picture. There was no response. Everybody kept in silence. The narrator was panic-stricken. He unwittingly got into a mental tight corner because in his pocket only 63 pounds. Is it clear, all of you? But picture sold how much price? 4,050 guineas. The narrator decided to confess his foolishness to the auctioneer. As soon as the hammer failed to indicate that the deal was closed for the highest bid amount of 4,050 guineas. He saw his friend for help, but his friend at a remote place of a hall, unable to control his laughter, Do you know why his friend was laughing? Because his friend, our narrator, never had a money. Only 63 pounds in his pocket. No one could help him also. So that is why narrator's friend was laughing. Narrator had only 63 pounds with him and he did not know how to manage the situation. He thought that of all his relations from whom he could borrow, he has known that no one could help him. A sudden stroke of luck befell the narrator when he heard from the agent. The agent wore a green apron, had made the bid of 4,000 guineas, would offer him the additional 50 guineas and buy the picture. He was about to weep in joy because he became happy. He had a presence of mind, demanded the agent for more guineas. He felt that it was no harm for asking a bit more. When the check for the amount was given to him, his joy doubled. Narrator got the amount and he got relieved from his mental tight corner. From this lesson, we came to know, have patience, be calm all the time in a silent. All things are difficult before they become easy. Is it clear? I hope you understand this lesson. Today, home assignment. Answer the following questions. What is the tight corner? What happens when one finds oneself in tight corner? What is the difference between a physical and mental tight corner? Next, why did the narrator visit Christie's? What is the reason he visited the Christie's? The narrator heard his own voice saying under 50. What does this suggest? What was the narrator's financial condition? The narrator could not pretend to have made a mistake in bidding. Why? What would have been the best way for the narrator to get himself out of the tight corner? Next, why did the narrator feel he could have welcomed a firing party? What was the bidders offered to your narrator? How did the narrator take advantage of the situation? Totally 10 questions are there and 2 more paragraph questions. Narrate the circumstances that led to the narrator getting to a tight corner by his own folly. Trace the thoughts that went on in the mind of the narrator when picture after picture was put up and sold at the auction. So totally 12 questions. Write the answer and send it to your respective teachers. Thanks for watching.